Hello everyone, for this tutorial video, I'd like to explain how integrals are used in the study of statistics with something known as probability density functions. A probability density function is simply a function that tells you the distribution of a probability. For example, the bell curve is a probability density function because it tells you the greatest likelihood of something occurring is near the center, while the least likelihood is farthest from the center. Mathematically, probability density functions must satisfy two equations, which are: function of x must return a value greater than or equal to 0 for all x's, and that the integral from infinity to negative infinity of this function must be exactly 1. For example, if we were given this function and told that it is only that function between 0 and 10 and exactly 0 for everything else, we would show that it is a probability density function by using the integral rule. So we see, because we have limits 0 and 10, we do not actually need infinity and negative infinity here. We only need 10 as the upper limit and 0 as the lower limit. So now we compute the indefinite integral, compute the value at 10, and subtract the value at 0, which nicely enough is 0, so we need to worry about the value at 10. And in conclusion, the value at 10 calculates to 1, so we have satisfied the probability density function. So now, if we wanted to figure out specific probabilities, such as that x lands between 1 and 4, we would calculate the integral from 1 to 4, which would be integral at 4 minus integral at 1, and get this number. And if we were asked to find the probability that x is greater than or equal to 6, we would see the upper limit of 10 is implied here, as we assume you remember that the problem said the maximum value of the function was 10. So now we take the integral at 10 minus the integral at 6, and we get this finite value. Now that we have seen how probability density functions work, we can discontinue conversations about integrals and start discussing parametric equations in the next tutorial video, or equations where x and y are related to a third variable called a parameter, rather than y being a direct function of x. Don't forget to subscribe if you found this video informative, and make sure to see other tutorial videos, and follow me on either Facebook or Twitter for more content.